The multinational development banks assisted the Uzbek government with preparing the auctions and engaging with the private investors. Renewable energy capacity are needed in Uzbekistan to address the climate change, but it shouldn't endanger biodiversity. In June 2022, Bank Watch visited the project site for the Zarafshan and Bash wind power plants in Uzbekistan. This project will be supported by the EBRD, ADB and IFC.
We're now close to the city of Zarafshan in central Uzbekistan. Behind me on the top of these hills, there's a plan to build the 500 megawatt Zarafshan wind farm. The problem is that it's a very pristine area with a lot of endangered bird species which are nesting on the cliffs just behind me. The wind farm, in fact, it will be very difficult to mitigate the impacts on these species. We're now in the Tamdi region next to Zarafshan, and Aktau Tamdi was supposed to be declared a national reserve. There was a lot of scientific information about the need to protect it as a national reserve. For example, the Argali, the wild sheep, this is the only place in the desert area where it is still found. And the Saker falcon, one of the rarest falcons in the world, also breeds here, and many vultures. In fact, we have done just half an hour trip along the lake, and there are many breeding birds here. There are many waders which migrate during the night, and probably they can have a very big chance to be killed by the wind farms. It's great that the European Bank for Reconstruction and Development and other international financial institutions are financing renewable energy. The bad part is that Uzbek government and the investors are not choosing the right places. There are so many huge areas, vast areas in the desert, in the steppes, where you can build a wind farm in Uzbekistan, but not so close to such an important lake, which is an important bird area.
Moreover, dozens of wind power projects in different regions of Uzbekistan are under development now, increasing the cumulative impact on the birds. However, no cumulative impact assessment has been carried out.